बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम, अस्सलाम वालेकुम स्टूडेंट्स। दिस इज़ आवर लेक्चर नंबर 22 फॉर द सब्जेक्ट ऑफ ऑपरेशंस मैनेजमेंट। स्टूडेंट्स, इन द लास्ट क्लास वी डिस्कस्ड अबाउट अ न्यू टेक्निक दैट इज असाइनमेंट मॉडल। वी डिस्कस्ड अबाउट दिस पर्टिकुलर मेथड व्हिच वी यूजुअली यूज इन ऑपरेशंस मैनेजमेंट सेटिंग, दैट दिस सॉर्ट ऑफ मॉडल इज वेरी हेल्पफुल in assignment of different tasks to the different jobs in order to minimize the cost. So again, in this sort of problem we may be interested in maximization of profit, or we may be interested in minimization of cost. So for that particular purpose, these are very important and helpful method. In the last class we discussed a very important technique which is used for assignment models, that is Hungarian method, and there are the different steps which are involved in this Hungarian method, and I told you in detail about each of these steps, that whenever we want to use this assignment model in order to assign the different tasks or jobs to the different machines or to the different persons, then we'll have to follow these steps very strictly and very carefully, because if you will not follow these steps, you will not be able to find an optimal solution. And especially I give you some sub steps, so that if you follow these sub steps, you will not having any problem in solving these questions. And I told you that some of these steps are not available in all the books, and in some books they always use some intuitive or hypothetical method in order to find that optimal assignment. But if you follow these particular steps, then you will always be able to solve these problems. And let's briefly review these steps. Whenever we have this sort of problem, that is, we want to assign the different jobs to the different persons or machines, what we will have to do, we will have to formulate again this practical situation in the form of a table by taking either the machines or the persons on the left hand side of the table, and by taking the different jobs or the different tasks on the upper hand side of this table. So by representing all of these jobs and all of these persons in the form of table, you can always represent in this table for the different costs, that is the cost for assigning a particular job to a particular person. So after you will be able to make this table which shows the cost for each person assignment for a particular job, then we can always follow the different steps. And what are these steps? In the first step, what we will do, we will apply the row operation. And what is row operation? We will first find out the minimum number out of each row, and then we will subtract this minimum number from each value of the row. So this is usually referred as row operation. So after this row operation, we will apply the column operation. And again, in column operation, we'll find out the minimum value out of each column, and then one by one we will subtract this minimum value from all the values of respective columns. So after that column operation, we will have to check out that whether we can make the relevant assignments or not. In order to check this particular problem, we'll have to assign the different jobs to the different persons, and again we'll have to follow the different steps for this assignment. We should start from the first row. If there is a single zero in any row, we will assign this zero. Now assign means we can make square for this zero, and then we will see the respective column. If there are zeros in the respective or corresponding columns, we will cross out these zeros. Again, we will move to the next row. Again, if there is a single zero in this row, we will assign it, and we will cross down all the other zeros in the respective column. If there are more than one zero in any row, initially we will leave this row. This operation will be continued until we reached up to the last row, and then we will repeat the same steps for column. That is, we will start from the first column. If there is a single row in this column, we will assign this zero, and we will cross all the other zeros in the respective rows. Similarly, we can check the other columns. If there are more than one zero in any column, we will leave it. So we will complete this process up till we have checked for the last column. And again, we'll have to repeat these steps again and again until all the zeros in that particular table are either assigned or crossed. So after this step, you may be able to find the assignment. If you can have the different assignments for all the different persons, then of course this table may give you the optimal solution. But if you are not being able to have all the assignments for the different persons, you will have to move down to the next step. Next step again, class, is very important. This step further consists of some sub-steps. Now what we will do in this particular step, we will first tick down those rows which are unassigned. That is, tick down the unassigned rows. If this ticked row has a zero, we will tick the respective column. If this ticked column has an assignment, we will tick the respective rows. So these are very important steps, and we will go on that ticking unless we have all the relevant rows and columns ticked. And after this ticking, what we will do, we'll draw the lines on the unticked rows and the ticked columns. And these particular lines, that is the number of lines, will represent the number of assignments you have made in this particular table. So again, we'll have to move to the next step. We'll have to find out the minimum number through which lines are not being passed. So that minimum number will be added at the intersection of the rows and columned lines, and that particular number will be subtracted from the other numbers through which no line is being passed. There are the numbers through which the line is passed. We will keep these numbers as such. So these are some of the few steps. After doing this particular step, again we will repeat the third step. That is, again we'll have to check down the different rows, we'll have to make down the different assignments, and we'll have to cross down the respective zeros in the rows on the columns. So this process will be continued till you are being able to have the optimal assignments. So this was a brief review of the different steps we discussed in the last class. And again, this method is referred as Hungarian method. And last time we solved some problems related to this assignment methods. Today again, we will do some examples, and we will discuss that how we can apply all of these steps in order to find out the optimal assignment for the different machines or for the different jobs. So let's, class, discuss another example. Now in this problem again, class, we have four different machines, and there are four different jobs. The machines are M1, M2, M3 and M4, and the different jobs are J1, J2, J3 and J4. The table you can see on your slides, this table represents the cost of the particular assignment. That is, there is a cost of ₹2 or $2 if we assign the job J1 to machine M1. Similarly, we'll have to bear the cost $3 or ₹3 if we assign job J2 to machine M1. Similarly, if we assign this particular job J4 to a particular machine M4, we'll have to bear $20 of cost. So what is being required? We'll have to find out that which job is to assign to which machine to get the minimum cost. So again, we are interested to find out an optimal assignment so that we can minimize our cost. So let's, class, solve this particular example. Now let me again draw this particular table. There are four machines, that is M1, M2, M3, M4. There are four jobs, that is J1, J2, J3, J4, and the cost is already been given to you, that is 2, 3, 5, 4, 3, 8, 12 and 15, 4, 15, 17 and 18, then 5, 17, 18 and 20. So class, first of all, what we will have to do, we have to start from the first step, that is row operation. In order to do that row operation to this problem, what we will do, we'll have to find out the minimum number out of each row. So out of this row, the minimum number is 2. So let me write this 2 here. Out of this row, the minimum number is 3. 3. Out of this third row, the minimum number is 4. 4. Out of this fourth row, the minimum number is 5. So now what we will do, we will subtract these particular numbers from the respective rows. So class, if we subtract this number from the first row, that is 2 minus 2 will become 0, 3 minus 2 will become 1, 5 minus 2 become 3, 4 minus 2 will become 2. Similarly, we will subtract 3 from all of these values in second row, that is 3 minus 3 will become 0, 8 minus 3, it will be 5, 12 minus 3 will be 9, 15 minus 3, it will become 12. Similarly, we will subtract 4. Similarly, we will subtract 4 from a third row, that is 4 minus 4, 0. 15 minus 4, 11. 17 minus 4, 13. And 18 minus 4, 14. Now subtract 5 from the fourth row, that is 5 minus 5, it will become 0. 17 minus 5, it will become 12, 18 minus 5, it will be 13, and 20 minus 5, it will become 15. So what we have do class, we have just subtracted the minimum row values from all the relevant rows. Now as the next step, we will have to apply the column operation. So let me identify what is the minimum value in each column. In the first column, you can see in this particular table, the minimum value is 0. So you can always write those minimum values here so that you can easily subtract these values from the columns. In the second column, the minimum value is 1, so 1. In the third column, the minimum value is 3, so you can write 3 here. In the fourth column, the minimum value is 2, so you can always write 2 here. Now class, again we'll have to subtract these values from the respective columns. Now what we will do, we'll apply the column operation. So again we'll have to draw that table. again class, here are the jobs, that is J1, J2, J3, J4, and there are some machines, that is M1, M2, M3 and M4. In the first column, the minimum value is 0, so it means that first column will remain same, that is 0, 0, 0 and 0. In the second column, the minimum value is 1, so if we subtract 1, this will become 0, 4, 10, 11. 0, 4, 10, 11. Similarly, in third column, the minimum value is 3, so it will become 3 minus 3, 0, 9 minus 3, 6, 13 minus 3, 10, 13 minus 3, 10, so it will become 0, 6, 10, 10. 0, 6, 10, 10. In fourth column, the minimum value is 2, so 2 minus 2, 0, 12 minus 2, 10, 14 minus 2, 12, and 15 minus 2, 13, so it will become 0, 10, 12, 13. 0, 10, 12, and 13. 0, 10, 12, and 13. So, class, we have applied that row operation and column operation to our problem. Now, what we will do, we will have to move towards our next step. Now, let's start from this first row. You can see there are four zeros in this particular row, and if you remember and recall the different steps of Hungarian method, I told you that if there is more than one zero in a row, you can initially leave it. So initially we can always leave this particular row. If we move to the second row, you can see that there is a single zero in this particular row, so we can always assign this zero. So we can assign this zero by scaling. And again, we will have to cross down the other zeros in the corresponding column. Now, this is very important, class. We will have to cross down the other zeros in the corresponding column. Now, third row. In this row, you can see there is a single zero which has already been crossed. So, we will leave it. In fourth row, there is no other zero. There is a single zero which has already been crossed. So, same way, we will check column-wise. In the first column, you can see either all the zeros are crossed or assigned. So let's move to the second column. Now in this column, there is a single zero. So we will assign this particular zero and we will cross all the relevant zeros in the corresponding row. So we have assigned this zero, so its corresponding row is this one. So we will cross all of the zeros. This zero has already been crossed. So we will move to the third row. In this third row, there is a single zero which has already been crossed. In fourth row, there is a single zero which has already been crossed. So after doing this sort of operation, you can see from this table that all the zeros are either crossed or they are assigned. And you can see out of this table, we can have only two assignments. So it means that we cannot get the optimal solution from this particular table, and we will have to move towards the next step. Now class, again, we will use that technique of ticking. So as a first sub-step, what we will do, we will have to tick down the rows which are not being assigned. Now again, I am repeating, tick down the rows which are not being assigned. If you see the different rows, the first row has an assignment, so we will leave it. The second row has an assignment at this particular cell, so we will leave it. Now this is the row and this is the row which have no assignment. So what we will do, we will just tick down these rows. So this is the first sub-step. Now the next step is, if these ticked rows has zeros, we will tick the corresponding columns. You can see that if we see this particular row, this is the zero, so we will tick the corresponding column, this one. Similarly, this ticked row has the zero here, and again we will tick the relevant column which has already been ticked. So class, first of all, we will tick down the rows which are not assigned. If these ticked rows have zeros, then we will tick the corresponding columns. Again, if this ticked column, this one, has an assignment, this has an assignment, we will tick the corresponding row. So we will again tick this particular row. So these are three steps are so important for this ticking. That is, tick down the rows which are not being assigned. If the ticked row has a zero, we will tick the corresponding column. If the ticked column has an assignment, we will again tick the corresponding row. Now after this ticking, what we will do, we will draw the lines through the unticked rows and the ticked columns. You can see from this table that this row is ticked, this row is ticked, this row is ticked, this row is unticked. So we will draw the line through this unticked row and the ticked column. This column is ticked, so we will draw the line through this particular column. And now as a third step, now class, as the next step, what we will have to do, we will check all those numbers through which line is not being drawn. You can see the remaining numbers are 4, 6, 10, 10, 10, 12, 11, 10 and 13. Out of these numbers, what is the minimum number? The minimum number in this particular case is 4. So let me write this minimum number here. Minimum number is 4. So what we will do, we will subtract this number out of these numbers through which line is not being passed. So let me draw this particular table again. Now class, we will subtract this minimum number 4 from all of these numbers through which line is not being passed. So this is the relevant position of that particular cell. So 4 minus 4 will become 0, 6 minus 4 will become 2, 10 minus 4 will become 6, 10 minus 4, 6, 10 minus 4, 6, 12 minus 4, 8, 11 minus 4, 7, 10 minus 4, 6, and 13 minus 4, 9. Now, we will add this minimum number at the point where the row and the column, that is the lines, are intersecting with each other. You can see in the upper table that this is the cell where this row and this column is intersecting with each other. So at this point of intersection, we will add this minimum number 4. So it will become 0 plus 4. So here it will become 4. All the other values through which only the line is being passed will remain same. So these numbers will remain same. That is 0, 0, 0, and here again 0, 0, and 0. So in this way, we are being able to formulate this particular table. Now again class, we will have to repeat the similar steps. That is, we'll have to start from the first row. Now this is the first row. There is more than one zero. So we will initially leave this particular row. In the second row, two zeros, so just leave it. In third row, there is a single zero. So you can always assign this zero. And you should cross the all other zeros in the corresponding column. Again, in fourth row, there is no zero left because there is a zero which has already been crossed. So now we will move column wise. In first column, there is no zero left because either it is assigned or it is being crossed. In second column, there are two zeros. So we will again, we can leave this column initially. In third column, you can see that there is a zero, single zero, so we can always assign it, and we will cross the relevant zeros in the corresponding row. So again, we will check the fourth column. Fourth column, in fourth column, there is a single zero which has already been assigned. So again, class, you can see from this table that still there is a zero which is being left. So we will start the step again. Again, start from the first row, and you can see from the first row that there is no zero left which has not been crossed or assigned. In second row, there is a zero. There is a single zero because the other zero is crossed. So we can always assign this particular zero. So that's why we will move on repeating this step unless all the zeros are either assigned or they are being crossed. So that is very important that you will have to repeat down these steps unless you have crossed or assigned all of the zeros. So class, next we will move again to next step, that is the ticking method. Now again, tick the row which is not unassigned, that is tick the unassigned row. Now this is the row which is not assigned. Now you can see this row is assigned due to this assignment. This row has been assigned due to this assignment. This row has been assigned due to this assignment. This is row where there is no assignment. So we will tick this unassigned row. If this ticked row has a zero, we will tick the corresponding column. If this ticked column has an assignment, we will tick the corresponding row. So that step is completed. Again, we will draw the lines. Draw the lines on the unticked rows. These are the unticked rows. So we have draw the two lines and ticked column. This is the ticked column. So we will draw the line at this particular column. So again, we will have to repeat the step that we'll have to find out the minimum value out of this table through which line is not being passed. You can see from this table that there are six numbers through which line is not being passed, that is 6, 6, 8, 7, 6, 9. Out of these six numbers, the minimum number is 6. So let me write that minimum number here, that is minimum number is here in this case is 6. So when we will draw this table again, what we will do, we will subtract this minimum number from this number through which lines is not passed. We will add this minimum number at the intersection where the lines and the lines in rows and columns are intersecting with each other, and the remaining values will remain same. So students, let me draw this table again. So students, we will subtract this particular minimum number 6 from all the values where the line is not being passed. So this will become 002 at this particular cells, that is 002, and again 7 minus 6 1, 0 and 3, 1 0 and 3. 1 0 and 3. Now class, as you can see that this is the cell at which this horizontal line and vertical line is intersecting with each other. So we will add 6 to this particular cell as well as at this particular cell. This particular row line and column line is intersecting each other, so we will also add 6 at this particular stage, at this particular column. So we will add 6 at this particular cell also. So this value will become 4 plus 6, 10 and 6. So let me write here, that is 10 and 6. All the other values through which only the single line is being passed, that will remain the same. That is 0, 0, 0 and this 0 to 6. 0, 0, 0. So it will become 0 to 6. 0 to 6. And again, this value will also remain same, that is 0, 0, through which this line is being passed. So it will be again 0 and 0. So class, again I am repeating that after drawing those lines through the different rows and columns, what we did, we find out the numbers through which no line is passed. Out of these numbers we find out the minimum number, and we subtract this particular number from all the values through which line is not passed. We add this minimum number at the points where the horizontal lines and the vertical lines which we draw ourselves, at particular point we add this minimum number, then all the other values will remain same, through which only a single line is being passed. So we have a new table in this particular form. So again we'll have to repeat the step, that is we'll have to start from row 1. So if there are three row zeros in this particular row, so we will initially leave it. In this row there is a single zero, so we can always assign this zero, and we will have to cross all the other relevant zeros in the corresponding column. Now again in this zero you can see there are the two zeros, so we can leave it. In this particular row there are again two zeros, so we can always leave it initially. If we see this particular column, there are two zeros, so we can initially leave this column. In this zero there is no zero, there are two zeros, there are three zeros which are already been assigned or crossed, so we will leave it. In this particular column there are more than two zeros, and therefore we can always omit it, and we can move to the column number 4. In column 4 there is a single zero, so we can always assign this particular zero, and again we will cross these relevant zeros in the respective rows. Now again class, we'll have to go through the first step, because all the zeros are not being assigned or crossed. So let's start again from the different rows. From the first row you can see there is no zero spared, because the zeros have already been crossed or assigned. In second row again the only zero has already been assigned. In third row there are two zeros, so initially if you leave it and move to row 4, there are two zeros, so we can leave it. In first column there are two zeros, so if we leave it and move to second column, there is no spared zero. In third column again there are two zeros, we can leave it. In fourth column again there is no zero spared, there is a single zero which has already been assigned. Now students, this is a different situation which we have not yet discussed, that after completing that step again, that is starting again from the first row, what we got, that still we are not being able to have the assignment to any other zeros. Now why it's being happening? Because still there are two zeros in the different rows and two zeros in the different columns. So in this particular situation what we can do, we can assign to a zero to the very first available cell. So we can hypothetically assign this particular zero which is first available in third row. So let me assign this particular zero. So if we assign this zero, we'll have to cross down this if we assign this zero, we'll have to cross down this zero as well, because we cannot assign two jobs to one machine, and again we'll have to cross down this relevant column as well. And again we'll have to cross down this relevant cell, that is the zero in the respective column as well. So again I am repeating class, if this is the sort of situation when you have that more than one zero and more than one zero in the rows and columns, then what you can do, you can hypothetically assign a single zero and you can cross down the other zeros and columns in the rows and columns. So this is the way in this particular situation. Now again if we move to the fourth row, there is a single zero which is unassigned, so we can always assign it, and all the other zeros are already been crossed. Now you can see that we have the four assignments, that is this one, this one, this one. So it means that this table gives us the optimal solution actually. Now what should be the assignments, or how we should assign the different jobs to the different machines? Now this assignment is guiding us that job 4 should be assigned to machine 1. So that is M1 should be for job 4. Similarly, this second assignment J2 M2, M2 to J2. Now third assignment, that is J1 to M3. And this fourth assignment, that is J3 to M4. So this is the optimal assignment class, and in order to find out the minimum cost, that if we are going to apply this assignment plan, what will be the minimum cost? Again, you will have to refer to the very initial table in which costs are given. Now this is the table. Now class, our first assignment is M1 to J4, M1 to J4. So there is $4 cost for this particular assignment. So let me write $4 here for this assignment. Then M2 to J2. Now M2 to J2, $8 is the cost. $8. Similarly, M3 to J1. M3 to J1, $4 is the cost. So this is $4, and then M4 to J3. M4 to J3. Now this is $18. This is $18. If we sum up all of these values, it will become 8 plus 8, 16, plus 18, 34. So class, this is our minimum cost. So if we assign job 4 to machine 1, job 2 to machine M2, job J1 to machine M3, and job J3 to machine M4, then we can have the minimum cost for this assignment plan. So this is the way that how we can achieve that optimal solution for the different assignment problems. Now let's discuss another similar problem in order to find out the optimal assignment plan. Okay class, let me write down this table again. Now class, again in this particular problem, we have the different machines, that is M1, M2, M3, M4. There are four different jobs, that is J1, J2, J3, G4, J4. So we'll have to assign these jobs to the different machines so that our cost may be minimum. So this is J1, J2, J3 and J4, and this is M1, M2. M3 and M4. Let me write down their relevant cost, that is 5, 7, 11 and 6. 5, 7, 11, 6. 8, 5, 9, 6. 8, 5, 9, 6. 4, 7, 10, 7. 4, 7, 10, 7. And 10, 4, 8, 3. 10, 4, 83. So class, I have just rewrite this particular table, and again class, we'll have to follow the same rule, that is the first step of row operation. Now again, write the minimum row values here. Out of this row, the minimum value is 5. In the second row, the minimum value is 5. In third row, the minimum value is 4. In fourth row, the minimum value is 3. So what we will do, we will subtract this particular value from the different rows. Now class, first of all we will subtract this 5 out of the first row. So 5 minus 5 will become 0, 7 minus 5 2, 11 minus 5 6, 6 minus 5 1. Similarly, we will subtract 5 from the second row. 8 minus 5 will become 3, 5 minus 5 0, 9 minus 5 4, 6 minus 5 1, 4 from the third row, 4 minus 4 0, 7 minus 4 3, 10 minus 4 6, 7 minus 4, 3. Again, we will subtract 3 from the 4th row. 10 minus 3, 7. 4 minus 3, 1. 8 minus 3, 5. 3 minus 3, 0. So this is what we have done in this particular step, that we find out the minimum value out of each row and we subtract that particular value from each respective row. In the next step, we'll have to apply the column operation. So let me write here the minimum values in the relevant columns. In this particular column, you can see that the minimum value is 0. In this particular column, the minimum value is 0. In this particular column, the minimum value is 4. And in this particular column, the minimum value is again 0. So we will now subtract this minimum value from each column. So class, let me again draw that table. So class, if we subtract this minimum value 0 from the first column, the first column will remain same. That is 0 minus 0, 0, 3 minus 0, 0, 0 minus 0, 0, and 7 minus 0 will remain 7. So 0, 3, 0, 7. 0, 3, 0, 7. 0, 3, 0, 7. This is our first column. The second column will also remain same because the minimum value in this column is also 0. So this will remain 2, 0, 3, 1. 2031. In third column, the minimum value is 4, so we will subtract this 4 from each value of third column. 6 minus 4 2 2021. So this particular column will become 2021. Similarly, in the last column, you can see that the minimum value is 0. So if you subtract 0 from these values, it will remain same. So 1130. 1130. So class, now we will move to the next step. That is, we will have to start from the first row. As you can see that in this first row, there is a single 0. So we can always assign this 0. And we will have to cross the other zeros in the respective columns. So we will cross this particular 0. Now move to the second 0. Now move to the second row. In this row there are the two zeros, so we will leave it initially. In third row there is no zero left. There is a single zero which is already been crossed. In third, in fourth row there is a single zero, so we will assign this particular zero. and again we will cross the other zeros in the respective column. There is no other zero in the respective column, so it will remain same. Now we will check it column wise. In first column there are two zeros which are already been assigned or crossed. In second column there is a single zero, so we can assign this particular zero, and again we'll have to cross down the other zeros in respective rows. So we have crossed down it. In third column there is no zero left. In fourth column there is no zero left. There is a single zero which has already been assigned here. So after this step you can see from this table that all the zeros are either been crossed or they are being assigned, and we have only three assignments in this particular table. So it means that we'll have to move down to the next step, that is we'll have to use that ticking method. So first step, tick down the unassigned rows. So again you can see that the first row is assigned. Assignment means there is a single assignment in this particular row. In second row there is an assignment. In third row there is no assignment. In fourth row there is also the assignment. So it means that there is only one row, that is the third row, in which there is no assignment. So tick the unassigned row if this ticked row has a zero. Now here is the zero, then tick the corresponding column. So we will tick this corresponding column. If this ticked column has an assignment, this is the assignment, we will tick the corresponding row. So we will tick this corresponding row. So this is the way we will repeat and use these steps for solving our assignment problems. Now as a next step, what we will do, we'll have to draw the lines on the unticked rows and the ticked columns. So you can see there are two unticked rows, that is this one unticked row in which there is no ticked, and there is a single unticked column. Now we will cross or draw the line on this column, ticked column. So students, now we'll have to find out the number through which no line is being passed. You can see from this table that this is the number, that is 2, 2, 1 and 3, 2, 3. Out of these numbers there is no line passed. Out of these numbers we will find out the minimum value. So you can see out of these numbers the minimum value is 1. So let me write this minimum value here. Minimum value is equal to 1. So what we will do, we will reformulate our table. Now class, we will subtract this minimum number 1 from all the values through which line is not being passed. So these are the numbers through which the line is not passed. So it will become 2 minus 1, 2 minus 1, 1, 1 minus 1, 0. So it will become at the particular position, please be careful, that is 1, 1 and 0. And this is the particular numbers through which line is not passed. So again we will subtract 1 from this from these numbers, that is 3 minus 1, 2, 2 minus 1, 1, 3 minus 1, 2, and again find out the points of intersection where the horizontal lines and the vertical lines are intersecting with each other. You can see that this is the particular cell where the horizontal line and the vertical line is intersecting, as well as at this particular cell the horizontal line and the vertical line is intersecting. So we will add this minimum number 1 to these points of intersection. So it will become 3 plus 1, that is 4. At this particular position it will become 4, and this is the point of intersection, it will become 7 plus 1 is equal to 8. So it will become 8. All the other values through which a single line is being passed will remain same. So it will be in same 1, 1, 0, and this 0 will remain same, and this 0 will remain same, and this particular 0 will also remain सेम दैट इज 0 0 1. So class, again we are having this table, and again we'll have to repeat those steps. That is, we'll have to assign the zeros, and we will start again from row 1. You can see in the row 1 there are two zeros, more than one zero, so we will initially leave it. In second row there are also two zeros, so again initially we will leave it. In third row there is a single zero, so we can always assign this zero. So let assign this particular zero and cross all the other zeros in the corresponding column. So we will cross this zero. Again in fourth row there is a single zero, so we will assign this zero and we will cross all the other zeros in the respective column. So cross this zero. Now again the same steps will be repeated for columns. In first column there is no zero left. There are two zeros, one is assigned, the other one is crossed. In second column there is a single zero, so we can assign this zero, and again we will cross the other zeros in the respective or corresponding rows. In third column there is no zero left. In fourth column there is no zero left, because either it is being assigned or it is being crossed. So again class, you can see that still we have three assignments. It means that still we cannot be able to have the optimal solution in this particular case. So again we'll have to repeat that ticking method. That is, tick the unassigned row. So this is the unassigned row in which there is no assignment. Tick the unassigned row. If the ticked row has a zero, now you can see that in this particular row there are two zeros. So if ticked row has a zero, tick the corresponding columns. So we'll have to tick two columns here, because this ticked row has two zeros. These are the corresponding columns. So we have ticked these two columns. Now if the ticked columns have an assignment, now you can see that this is the ticked column. It has the assignment. So we will tick the corresponding row. And again, this is the ticked column. It has also an assignment. So we'll again tick the corresponding row. So in this way you will complete your ticking. And again now we will draw the lines on the unticked rows. Now this is the unticked row and the ticked columns. Now there are two ticked columns, this one, and now this is the other ticked column. So we have draw line through the ticked columns. Now again class, we will have to find out the minimum number through which no line is being passed. So what is that minimum number? You can see there are six numbers, that is 1, 1, 2, 1, 1, 1, through which no line is being passed. So out of these numbers, minimum number is 1 of course. So now again we will repeat the same steps. In the next table we will minus these numbers from the values from which no line is being passed. We will add this number at the points of intersection of the vertical and the horizontal lines, and the remaining numbers will remain same. So let me draw this table again. Now class, let me fill this table. Now if we subtract this number from the numbers from which no line is passed, so 1 minus 1 and 1 minus 1, these two numbers will become 0. So please careful about the relevant position when you are filling the next table. So here these two values will become 0 and 0. That is the particular position, 0, 0. Now again these numbers will become 1 0 0 0. So these numbers will become 1 0 0 and 0. Now let's see the points of intersection. Now these are the points of intersection, that is 4. In this point of intersection we will add this minimum number 1, and again this is the point of intersection, we will add 1 here again. So these two values will become 2 and 5. Second row, 2 and 5. So these values will become 2 and 5. So we add that minimum number at the points of intersection of the lines. Now again the rest of the values will remain same, that is this this one, this 0 and this 2 and 0 will remain same. So 0, 2, 0. This value will also remain same, that is 0, 0, 0, 0. And again this value, that is 0, and this 0 and 8 will remain same. So 0, 0, 8. This is 0, 0 and 8. So again class, we have incorporated that particular step, that is we find out the minimum number after drawing the lines. That minimum number is subtracting from all those values through which no line is being passed. That number is being added at the points of intersection of the horizontal lines and the vertical lines, and that all the other values will remain same, through which only a single line is being passed. Now again class, we will have to repeat the similar step, that is we will have to start from the first row. Let's start from the first row. You can see there are more than one zero, so we will leave it. In second row there are two zeros, more than one zero, so initially you can leave it. In third row again there are two zeros, you can leave it. In fourth row more than one zero, so initially you can leave it. Next, in first column more than one zero, leave it. In second column more than one zero, you can leave it. In third column more than one zero, so you can leave it. In fourth column again more than one zero, so you can leave it. So again class, this is the same situation I told you in our last problem, that sometimes we don't have any row or column in which there is a single zero. Now that is the particular situation in which we can assign the first available cell as our assignment. So you can see in this particular table there is not a single zero in any row or column. So what we will do, we will just assign hypothetically the first row, that is this one. So we can always assign this first cell. And again, if you are going to assign this particular cell, what we will have to do, we will have to cross down all the other zeros in that rows and all the zeros in the relevant columns, because again the assumption is that we will have to give one job to only one machine. Now again we can repeat the similar step, that go to the next row more than one zero, leave it. Third row, now in third row there is a single zero, so you can always assign this zero and always cross the other zeros in the relevant column. Now come to the fourth row, there is no single zero, two zeros, so you can leave it. Again start from the column, in column there is no spare left. In first column there is no zero spared, there are two zeros which are either been assigned or crossed. In second column there are two zeros, so you can leave it. In third column all the zeros are either being assigned or crossed. In fourth column you can see that there is a single zero and you can always assign it, but you will have to cross down all the other zeros in the respective rows. Still you can see that there is a single zero which is unassigned. So we will repeat this step again and again start from the first row. Again in the first row you can see that there is no zero spared, or the zero are either assigned or crossed. In second row there is a single zero now, and you can always assign it, and after assigning it you will see the relevant column. All the relevant column zeros are already being crossed. So you can see that from this table now we are having four assignments. So it means that this particular table will give you the optimal assignment. And again, what is the optimal job assignment? that is you'll have to assign job 1 to machine 1, job 2 to machine 2, job 3 to machine 3, and job 4 to machine 4. So this is the optimal assignment plan. And what is the relevant cost? Again, for the relevant cost, you'll have to refer to the original table in which the cost is given. So if our assignment is J1 to M1, the relevant cost you can see is the $5 or 5 rupees. So this is equal to 5. The cost is equal to 5 here. J2 to M2. Again, J2 to M2, the relevant cost is 5. Again, this is 5. J3 to M3, the relevant cost is 10 and 3. J4 to M4, 10 and 3. So this is 10 and this is 3. If we add up this cost, this will become 23. So class, this is the minimum cost. So students, now we have practiced 2 to 3 questions, and you must have the idea that how we can use that algorithm or that Hungarian method, actually, that is the step-by-step approach, in order to find the optimal assignments for our operations. And again, you can be now well aware of the importance of this technique, that how this technique can always help you to make the good decisions that is always based on the certain calculations and certain facts. Now, up till now, we discussed about the minimization of cost or minimization of time, in which we are always interested in minimizing as far as that transportation model is concerned. In the next class, inshallah, we will discuss that what will be the difference in the different steps if we want to maximize something. So if you are interested in maximization, what will be the different step involved in this assignment model. So class, this is all for today's lecture, and I wish you good good luck, and take care. Khuda hafiz.